Dear viewers, welcome to Food Microbiology. In this session, we will know about characteristics of microorganisms in food. Microorganisms play a major role in the foods. Either they can add value to the food by fermentation or cause spoilage, making them unfit to eat. Some microbes may cause diseases by spreading through foods. Molds like Aspergillus, Penicillium, Rhizopus, and bacteria like Pseudomonas are examples to spoilage organisms. Lactic acid bacteria are prominently used for food fermentations. Microorganisms include both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes are microscopic single-celled organisms in which the nuclear material is not enclosed in a nuclear membrane. They have a genetic material in the form of single continuous strand forming coils or loops, for example bacteria and cyanobacteria. Eukaryotes are the organisms that possesses a definite or true membrane bound nucleus. Genetic material is arranged in the form of chromosomes. Yeast, molds, plants and animals are examples to eukaryotes. In this unit, you will know about the following aspects: morphology of bacteria, structure of the bacteria, morphology of fungi, spores of microorganisms, significance of spores in food microbiology, and association of minerals in foods. First, we will know about morphology of bacteria. Bacteria are very small creatures and cannot be seen with naked eyes. Bacteria have a diameter of 0.5 to 1 micron. These are simplest of prokaryotes. Bacteria can survive extreme conditions of pH, temperature, oxygen tension, atmospheric pressures, and osmotic conditions. Bacteria can be found everywhere in this universe. Bacteria appear in different shapes like rods, spherical, and spiral. Rod-shaped bacteria are known as bacilli and may appear as a single or in chains, as shown in figure. Very rarely, they appear in pairs, for example, diplobacilli. A majority rods are with blunt ends, except a few with tapered ends, for example, diplobacilli, pneumonia, streptobacilli, and anthrax. Some appear with pin-headed thickening, like diphtheria bacteria, or lateral branching, for example, tuberculosis and leprosy bacteria. Cells of Corynebacterium diphtheriae stay side by side, which is known as palisade arrangement. Spherical shaped bacteria are also known as cocci or coccus. They may appear as a single in pairs, for example, diplococci, or in chains like streptococci. Sometimes they appear as a group of 4 pediococci or 8 sarcina, or in bunches, staphylococci. Spiral-shaped bacilli are known as spirilla. Rod-shaped bacteria exhibit different forms. They may be small rods or long rods. All the bacteria do not have the same size. Some of the examples are given here. A spiroplasma is having 0.1 micron in size, and Spirillum volutans is having 16 to 18 microns in size. And most of the pathogenic bacteria have a size of 0.2 to 10 microns. Neisseria meningitis has 1 micron, and Streptococcus pneumonia 1.25 micron, and Clostridia botulinum is having 3 to 8 microns in size, whereas Vibrio cholera is having 1 to 5 microns, and Typhonema palladium is having 8 to 14 microns. Now we will know about structure of the bacteria. Although bacteria are tiny creatures, they have very complex structure. Some have a capsule surrounded by them. Bacteria have a cell wall. It gives a shape to it. Some have filamentous appendages like pilae or flagella, as shown in the figure. Cell membrane is located below the cell wall. Ribosomes, mesosomes, nuclear material, storage granules, photosynthetic apparatus are present in the cytoplasm. The capsule is a loose aggregate of material. It gives protection and unfavorable conditions. It also acts as a storehouse of the food, as shown in the figure. Based on the size, it is classified as microcapsule and macrocapsule. Microcapsule cannot be seen under the microscope, whereas macrocapsules can be seen under microscope. The capsule forms a raft, for example, leukonostuc. A capsule is secreted by cell wall and composed of polysaccharides and polypeptides. Bacterial capsules are species specific. Next, cell envelope in gram-negative bacteria is composed of 2 unit membranes separated by a space called periplasmic region, as shown in the figure. The outer membrane is the cell wall, and the inner membrane is known as cytoplasmic membrane. Inner membrane contains proteins, lipids, and enzymes in mosaic manner. It acts as a barrier. Its structure is best explained by fluid mosaic model of Singer and Nicholson, as shown in the figure. In gram-positive bacteria, the outer membrane is absent. However, it has a thick peptidoglycan layer amounting to 90% of the cell wall. In gram-negative bacteria, outer layer contains a unique lipopolysaccharide and lipoproteins. It has only 5 to 10% of peptidoglycan. Cell wall provides structural integrity. It serves as a receptor. Cell wall is present in all prokaryotes except in Halobacterium and Halococcus species. Amino sugars like N-acetylmuramic acid and N-acetylglucosamine are present in cell wall. Pentaglycine bridges link adjacent amino sugars through tetrapeptide side chains. Mesosomes are more frequent in gram-positive bacteria. All important cell functions are attributed to it. It coordinates in septum formation during cell division. It acts like mitochondria of eukaryotes. Bacteria accumulate their energy reserve in the form of storage granules. These are of three types. One is polymetaphosphates, second is polybeta hydroxybutyrate, and third polyglucans. Next, fimbriae or pilea are hair-like structures and are present only in gram-negative bacteria. Based on their functions, pilea are of six types. Some pilea help in transfer of genetic material during conjugation, as shown in the figure. Flagella. It is a long filamentous-like structure which helps in creeping and swimming of bacteria. Flagella are arranged in four different ways. It may be only one flagellum at one end of the cells, like in case of monotrichates, for example Vibrio, or more than one at one end, it is known as lipotrichates, for example Pseudomonas. Many flagella are at both ends, like amphitrichates, for example in Spirillum. Or many flagella around the cell can be seen in case of peritrichates, for example Salmonella, as shown in the figure. It has a complex structure, as shown in the figure. In bacteria, the nuclear material is known as nucleoid. It lacks histone proteins. It is either folded or supercoiled. Bacteria have a plasmids. These are also known as episomes. These are extrachromosomal genetic units present in bacteria. These are circular double-stranded DNA that exist independently of nucleoid. They carry genes for various functions like resistance to antibiotics, transfer of sex factors, production of toxins, bacteriocins, and tumors. Now we will know about morphology of fungi. Fungi belong to eukaryota kingdom. Eukaryotic organisms lack plastids. Its cell wall contains chitin and beta glucans. Fungi may be unicellular or filamentous in appearance. They reproduce by either sexually or asexually. Fungi are saprophytic, parasitic, are mutualistic in their nutrition requirement. The fungi that have filamentous structure are referred to as molds, and most of these appear as unicellular organisms. Now we will know about structure of molds. The somatic structure of many molds looks like tubes or threads. These are known as hypha, which may be septate or non-septate. A mass of hypha is called mycelium. Its cell wall is very complex in nature. Cell wall contains cellulose and chitin, hemicellulose and lignin. Fungi have definite nucleus. It may be single or many. Haustoria can be seen in parasitic fungi. Haustoria are absent in vitro cultures and in saprophytes. Some fungi produce sclerotium. It is a hard resting body resistant to adverse conditions. Glycogen is a main storage material in fungi. The major components of fungal cell wall include cytoplasm, cytoplasmic membrane, mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, centrioles, ribosomes, lysosomes, nucleus, and vacuoles, as shown in the figure. Lipids are the main storage compounds in fungi, and these are placed in vacuoles. Mitochondria are site of respiration. Endoplasmic reticulum is the site of protein synthesis. Golgi apparatus helps to import and export of proteins. Nucleus is relatively small and carries genetic material. The nucleus of eukaryotes contains histone proteins. In fungi, the ribosomes are of ATS type. Now we know about structure of yeast. Yeast are another predominant group of microorganisms in foods. Many yeasts are useful for food preparations, for example, wine and bread. Some yeasts are responsible for food spoilage due to their metabolic activities, for example, Jagos saccharomyces. The shape and size of the yeast varies depending on the genus it belongs to. For example, Saccharomyces contains a width of 2.5 to 10.5 microns and a length of 4.5 to 21 microns, whereas Candida tropicalis having a width of 4 to 8 microns and a length of 5 to 11 microns. Yeast may be round, ovoid, ellipsoidal, filamentous, cylindrical, lemon-shaped, etc. Similar to bacteria and molds, yeast cell wall is also rigid and provides shape to the cell, as shown in the figure. It accounts for 25% of dry cell weight. The cell wall in baker's yeast consists of 83% carbohydrates, and glucose is the major carbohydrate. It has a single birth scar and several bud scars on its surface. The number of bud scars depends on the number of daughter cells produced by a mother cell, as shown in the figure. Some yeast have capsular material surrounding to its cells, and it is antigenic in nature. The genus can be identified by the type of capsular material it has. Fimbriae are present in some yeast. It is a proteinaceous and having a diameter of 5 to 7 nanometers. Cytoplasmic membrane is explained by fluid mosaic model. It contains various enzymes, neutral lipids, free and esterified sterols, neutral and acidic glycolipids, etc. The nucleus has porous nuclear membrane. It has a DNA and RNA. Other components of cell includes ribosomes, mitochondria, RNA polymerases, respiratory enzymes, Golgi bodies, etc. Microbodies which resemble peroxisomes of plants and present only in certain species. RNA content is 5 to 100 times more than DNA. Now we will know about spores of microorganisms. First, we will see about bacterial endospores. Endospores are resistant bodies produced only by some gram-positive bacteria like Bacillus, Clostridia, Sporobacillus, Sporocercina, and Disulfutamaculum. In essence, these are not real spores used for propagation of the bacteria. Endospores are formed for the survival of producing bacteria. Endospores have spore coat, cortex, and protoplast, also known as core. Cortex separates spore coat and core. The core contains cytoplasm and nuclear material. Cortex has many layers of peptidoglycan, as shown in the figure. Endospores contain dipicolinic acid, which binds to calcium and forms calcium dipicolinate. This gives more protection to the bacterial spore. In Bacillus cereus, an exosporium, an outer covering, is also present. Vegetative growth and cell division cease during sporulation. Endospores may be present at central, subterminal, or terminal location of the bacterial cell, as shown in the figure. Endospores may be an oval or spherical in shape, and each cell will produce only one endospore. Now we will know about fungal spores. Fungi produce spores by both sexual and asexual process. The spores produced by different fungi differ in their shape, color, and size. Hence, these are used for identification and classification of fungi. These spores are formed by hyphae that involve in reproduction. In asexual reproduction, fungi produce different types of spores in great abundance. These are capable of dormancy. These spores help in disseminating the species for a long distance. These asexual spores may be in different colors like green, yellow, red, brown, black, and orange, or colorless. If hypha breaks into individual cells forming the spores, then these are known as ovidia. These are produced externally, as shown in the figure. Arthrospores are another type of asexual spores produced by fungi. If these are surrounded by thick walls, then these are all called as chlamydospores. All spores are not motile. Motile spores are also known as zoospores or planospores, and they may have one or two flagella. If spores are produced internally in a sporangium, then they are called as sporangiospores. Conidiophores are spores formed externally over a conidium. Ascospores and basidiospores are examples to spores produced by sexual reproduction process. These are produced inside the ascus or outside of the basidium respectively, as shown in the figure. 8 ascospores are formed in one ascus, whereas 4 basidiospores are formed externally over a special growth known as stigmata on a basidium. Now we will know about yeast spores. Yeast also produce spores both by sexual and asexual reproduction methods. Asexual spores are of 4 types. These are blastospores, arthrospores, ballistospores and chlamydospores. Yeast spores appear in 10 different shapes. These are spherical, smooth, bowler hat shaped, Saturn shaped, bean shaped, spherical and warty, walnut shaped with equatorial rim and thick warty wall, sickle shaped, bow shaped, needle shaped and needle shaped with a non-motile flagellum. A comparison of the fungal and bacterial spores are presented in the table. Now we will know about the significance of the spores in food microbiology. Spores of either bacteria or fungi have several roles in food microbiology. Endospore forming bacteria may enter foods either directly or indirectly through soil. Endospores are produced by both aerobic and anaerobic bacteria. Endospores can create spoilage in foods, especially in canned foods. If the heat treatment is improper, in fact, the heating process may kill vegetative cells of bacteria. However, it activates the endospores, leading to the growth of spore forming bacteria, and this in turn can grow in the food. Anaerobic spore forming bacteria like Clostridia species can cause havoc in insufficiently processed canned foods. Aerobic spore formers like Bacillus can cause flat sore spoilage, wherein cans remain flat without any gas production inside it. For example, thermophilic Bacillus coagulans produces acidity in canned tomato products without any gas production. Some thermophilic anaerobic Clostridia produce thermophilic anaerobic spoilage by producing both acid and gas, leading to bulging of the cans, especially when stored at high temperatures. Spores of Clostridia nigrificans can cause sulfide stinker spoilage by producing hydrogen sulfide in low acid foods like peas and corn. Some of these spore forming bacteria like Bacillus cereus, Clostridia perfringens, Clostridia botulinum, etc. are also pathogenic. Once growth occurs, they may lead to production of various toxins, some of which are heat stable, hence can make foods unsafe for consumption. If heat treatment is applied, it may bring changes in sensory and textural properties of the foods. Hence, it is important to ensure that foods are not contaminated with the spore-forming bacteria. Alternatively, the processed foods should be kept in cold temperature so that the activated endospores cannot grow at this cold temperature. Fungal spores can easily be transported by wind currents and may enter the food when they are kept open. Most of the fungal spores enter the foods through air. Food being a rich source of nutrients, fungal spores, if entered into foods after processing, can grow well, leading to spoilage of the food. Some of the fungi can produce heat-resistant mycotoxins, which can even cause cancers in human beings. For example, asparagus flavor produces aflatoxin and acrotoxin. Penicillium expansion produces petulin. Penicillium citrinum produces citrinin, whereas Fusarium roseum produces geraniline, for etc. Now we know about association of minerals in foods. Many of the cereals based foods contain minerals such as phosphorus, zinc, iron, calcium, magnesium, manganese and copper. These are essential components required for human nutrition. Minerals are required to activate enzymes to regulate the pH of the body fluids and to maintain osmotic balance between the environment and the cells. deficiency of minerals can lead to severe metabolic disorders. More than 60% of phosphorus in cornmeal is bound to phytate, making it unavailable to the body. Phytate is considered as anti-nutritional factor, as it gives a negative effect on mineral uptake from the cereal foods like finger millet, sorghum, and corn. It can bind phosphorus, iron, zinc, copper, manganese, and calcium, making these minerals unavailable to the consumers. One of the easy methods to reduce the phytate content in the foods is fermentation. Microorganisms like aspergillus and some lactic acid bacteria present in fermented foods can hydrolyze phytates by producing the enzyme phytase. This step releases phosphorus, which can be absorbed by the body. Similarly, many animal and poultry feeds are being supplemented with phytase enzyme produced by Asparagus niger to increase the bioavailability of phosphorus in animals and birds. Natural fermentation of foods also improves HCl extractability of several minerals like zinc, iron, calcium, copper, and manganese in millet flour. Fermentation of cassava, which is known as tapioca, enhanced bioavailability of calcium, potassium, and magnesium. In conclusion, in this unit, it is explained about different microorganisms, their classification into prokaryotes and eukaryotes, important features of bacteria, molds, and yeast. You also learned about different types of spores of microorganisms produced either by sexual or asexual reproduction methods. Bacterial endospores, which are heat and radiation resistant, can play a significant role in the spoilage of various foods, especially canned foods. Fermentation of foods through desirable microorganisms can enhance the bioavailability of several minerals for human and animal nutrition. Thank you.